Hello everyone, today we will be discussing problem C from Code Forces round 538. For detailed problem statement, follow the link in the description. What you are given is, you are given N and B. And what you need to tell is, the number of trailing zeros in N factorial, where it is represented in base B. When it is represented in base B. Okay, so first of all, let's think about this in decimal based system that we are very used to with. So suppose the question would have been, tell me the number of trailing zeros in N factorial in base 10 representation. How would you have approached this problem? Okay, so first thing is, we'll write this 10 in its prime factorization form. So 10 is basically equals to 2 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 1. Why I have written this, I will tell you in short time. So how to find the number of trailing zeros in n factorial in base 10? In n factorial, the number of times you will have 10 as a factor, those many times you will have a trailing zero. For example, let's consider n to be equals to 5. Okay, then n factorial is going to be 120, and we can see that we have one trailing zero here. So the answer should have been 1 if it is in base 10. So what are we doing here is, if we look into 120, how is it represented? It is basically 10 into 12. You can further break 10 into 2 into 5, and 12 you can break into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, so prime factorization basically comes out to be 2 to the power 3 into 3 to the power 1 into 5. This was 120, okay, and 10 is 2 into 5. As I said, to find out the number of trailing zeros in base 10, you need to find out how many times you can have 10 as a factor. So in this number, how many times can you have 10 as a factor? Let us count the number of 2's we can have here. So number of 2's we can have here is 3. Number of 5's we can have here is 1. Okay. So I have 1 5 and 3 2's. And as I know that I can use 1 5 and 1 2 to form a 10. So to form 10, how many 10's I can form with this? It's very simple. You take minimum of 3, 1, which is basically 1. So you can form 1 10. Why? Because you don't have 2 5's to make it 2. Even though you have 3 2's, but you need 1 5 and 1 2 to form a 10. Okay? Let's take this problem to base B. In base B, to find the number of trailing zeros, you need to find the number of times B appear as a factor. In base 10, what we were doing, we were looking the number of times 10 appear as a factor in n factorial. So if you want to solve this problem in base B, it is simply finding the number of times B appear as a factor in n factorial. Now the thing is, how will you find number of times B is a factor in n factorial? How will you do this? Now the first thing is, you need to know how to form a B. For that, you will do prime factorization of B, like we did here in case of 10. So once you have the prime factorization of B, now you know how many 2's, 3's or 5's you need in this n factorial. Now the thing is, you see here in case of 10, we needed 1, 2 and 1, 5. Now in n factorial, we also need to count the number of 2's or 5's we have. How to do that? Okay, so we have a simple formula here. So in case you want to find the number of times x appear as a factor in n factorial, it is simply summation of I is equals to 1 to infinity n divided by that number x to the power I. So to illustrate this, if you want to find the number of times 5 appear, okay,
in say like 37 factorial. So I will write this as 37 divided by 5 plus 37 divided by 5 square plus 37 divided by 5 cube plus and so on. Now you can see that after a few terms, this thing will turn out to be 0. So we will just take this sum. Okay. Now one more thing to notice here is, I am just writing 37 divided by 5, but actually it is a flow value. You need not to consider the fractional part of it. Okay. So if you do this, you can find the number of times a number appears in n factorial. So using that, you can solve this problem. How? Let us look into a problem. Say like, you want to find the number of zeros in n factorial, where n is 5 and base is 12. Okay? So we know 5 factorial is 120. Now 120 in base 12 is basically a 0. Okay? 120 in base 12 is a 0. Now how will we find that we have one trailing 0 in 5 factorial in base 12? First write the prime factorization of 12. What is prime factorization of 12? Is 2 into 2 into 3, which is basically 2 to the power 2 into 3. So to form 112, you need 2 2's and 1 3. Okay? So first of all, we'll count the number of 2's we get in 120. So number of 2's we have is 3. And number of 3's we have is 1. And number of 5's we have is 1. Okay? How to calculate this? You simply run this formula. You divide this 5. So to find how to find the number of 2's, you divide 5 by 2 plus 5 by 2 square plus 5 by 2 cube. From this everything will be 0. So what you have is, you have 2 plus 5 by 4 is 1. So basically number of 2's in 5 factorial is 3. Similarly, you can find the number of 3's and so on in this thing. So once you are done with this, now we know that we need 2 2's and 1 3 to form a 12. So how many 12's can you form with this? First I need to think how many pair of 2's can I get. I have 3 2's, so at max I can get 1 pair. So at max I can get 1 pair. 3's, I need 1 3, and here I am having 1 3. 1. Okay? So it is going to be minimum of these 2. So which comes out to be 1. Now one thing to notice here is, even though I have 3 2's, why I am able to take only 1? Because I need 2 2's and 1 3 to form a pair. So I basically divided 3 by 2, which is basically equal to 1. So these many 2's only I can use. Okay, for each of these I need 1 3. So if you do this, you can get an accepted answer. For implementation details, you can follow the link in the description. Happy coding.